Hi guys, Master Fitnex is here again. I'm back with another video. Please like, subscribe, and leave some comments, especially with this video. I want to start a debate. I wonder about your opinion, so I would love to have to write down your opinion and experience about these topics. Okay, remember, I'm only expressing my own free opinion here. I'm not affiliated with any company. I'm not selling anything. I'm not trying to people up on any products. Today I'm going to talk about, as the title says, lactogenin versus creatine. Now the reason I want to talk about this, because I have people asking me, people asking me, hey, listen, I'm taking both. Should I just drop the creatine and stay with the lactogenin, or which one is better? Is creatine better than lactogenin, or lactogenin with the other one? If I'm taking them together, what kind of side effects I can encounter? So to clear this things a little bit up, I'm going to tell you my experience and my opinion here. Now, a little bit about creatine. Just a few seconds to touch base. Your body has some creatine and it's stored in your muscle. 95% of them stored in your muscle. 5% stored in your brain. Creatine, when you supplement, helps increase your ATP. So the more ATP is available during training, the better you perform, the better cellular energy you have, the more reps you're able to do, the more muscle gain you're going to have. Creatine helps you also when you do high interval training, not just weightlifting. Also has a muscle volumizing effect in your body, so therefore you feel a little bit buffed and more fullness. Creatine lowers myostatin level, which is elevated myostatin level basically put you in a catabolic state. That means that you're not able to build muscle, okay? So lower myostatin level, you're able to build more muscle. Furthermore, also helps you with recovery, shortening your recovery time. You're not gonna be that sore much as long as you would be in otherwise. So creatine generally is a very good supplement. There is different type of creatine you can get on the market. Creatine monohydrate, old school, creatine, ethyl ester, hydrochloride, just a few of them. And if you take creatine monohydrate, you have to go through like a loading phase for a few days, which goes up to like 20 grams per day, up to 5 days, and then you cut it back to 3 to 5 grams, and then just maintain with that one. You don't have to cycle on creatine, so you can just keep taking it all year round. Actually, the longer you take it, the more benefits you're gonna have from it. Also, creatine helps not just your muscle, but your brain as well. More and more research coming out how it helps elderly individuals. So it's good for trained athletes or you gym guys and elderly people as well. Helps with mood, helps with memory function, how your brain function basically, enhance everything a little bit. So generally, creatine has some health benefits as well for your heart. Just one more thing to mention. Now, lactogenin on the other hand. Lactogenin is a plant-based steroid. It's come from the family of bassinol steroids, if I spell it right. Okay, has similar effect on the body like NFR, similar structure, like the anabolic compound of NFR. However, it's not a hormone, not a pro-hormone, and not affecting your testosterone. Estrogen is very safe for women to use, according to recent research. I come back to that later, why I'm saying that. So according to recent research, lactogenin is safe to use even for women. It's great for weight loss, toning, build muscle, keep you in anabolic because you increase your protein synthesis, the way your cells making protein up to 200% or more. Decrease recovery time. It lowers cortisol. So when you have lower level of cortisol, you sleep better, you have better mood, and also you are recovering faster. And indirectly, lower cortisol means more testosterone. Other hormones can function better. So lactogenin also helps with nitrogen balance in your body. So if you're in a positive nitrogen balance, you're able to build, you are more anabolic as well. So as you can see, both of them works, do the similar things. Both helps you to have more muscle stamina, more muscles. You more have more stamina, more strength. You're able to build more muscle with both supplement. Creatine increase your ATP. However, lactogenin, and this is where they kind of start to differ. Lactogenin affects your hormones, though. If it's not a testosterone, but your cortisol. And according to my research, another one as well, thyroid. It's enhancing your thyroid function. So you're going to have like a speed up faster metabolism. Thyroid affects and regulates many hormones in your body. So people, for example, have hypothyroidism, they don't function the same well, same way as a person with a normal thyroid function. They gain weight, etc., etc. So thyroid is a very, very important hormone in the body. Lexigenin affects that and also cortisol. Now, meanwhile, creatine not. Creatine, you don't have to cycle on it. As far as we know right now, you don't have to cycle on lexigenin either. You can take it long term because it's non-hormonal, supposedly. Which one you should take? Can you combine them together? According to my experience and some of my clients' experience, yes, you can combine together without any side effect. Lexigenin is kind of mixed with everything, and thanks God, creatine also is a type of supplement that can be mixed with many others as well. So yes, you can take them together. You can take them separately, but they're not working the same way. They somewhat work in different pathways. However, which one I'm leaning towards in this debate, creatine versus lexigenin or lexigenin versus creatine, I'm gonna go with creatine. Though I love lexigenin and I have taken lexigenin, I love training on lexigenin, it feels awesome. However, I encounter some side effects once I stop taking it. And also lexigenin is lacking research. There's not enough research on lexigenin yet. They need to be researched a little bit more on the hormonal effects. Meanwhile, they're saying it's very safe for women. I would approach everything with a little bit of cautions, and I would not take lexigenin nonstop all year round. If you take a bottle or two, you definitely have to take a break after that. Now, creatine, the other side, is the most researched, most well-known, safest ingredient supplement out there in the market. Decades of research has done about creatine and the safetiness of creatine. Maybe some people have some sort of kind of negative reaction to it, but the majority of the time it's pretty safe. Never encountered any side effect when I came off of it. I could take it 6 months, a year. I stopped using it. I just keep going and as like I did before. Except, you know, you might have a little bit less strength, you notice it in the gym, but no other type of side effects. That's my opinion. Let's start a debate. You guys tell me yours. Until then, see you in my next video coming up soon. Monster Fit next. Bye-bye.